Hi guys, it's Ben CG here, and today I want to talk about some of the first videos I'm going to be posting onto my YouTube channel. In my channel trailer, I did say that I was really interested in the Nordic countries, such as, you know, Norway and Sweden, Denmark, Finland, and particularly Iceland. I wanted to show you some of my videos from my old trips to Norway. So, the main thing I wanted to talk about today is how and why I fell in love with the Nordic countries. The Nordic countries, I mean, I know they're globally admired by a lot of people, but you know, if I think about the kind of people I want to speak to on my YouTube channel, I'm not sure they'll take quite as much of an interest in the Nordic countries as they would Japan, for example, because I know the J-vlogging community has a lot of wonderful people following it, and these people who follow the J-vlogging channels are interested in almost every aspect of Japanese daily life and culture and pop culture and everything. So it's going to be interesting to see if I can actually take that and apply it to the Nordic countries and get you as interested in them as you might be in Japan. So when I was a kid, I didn't really know a lot about other countries around the world. I mean, I always had a fairly well-travelled childhood. I actually spent 2.5 years of my childhood living in the French part of Switzerland in a very small town called Pont-Jean, very close to Geneva and the French border. And I haven't been back there at all since I left it when I was about 7 years old, and I really miss it. I do have a very special place in my heart for Switzerland. And actually, I also spent 1 year of my life when I was very young, I think 4 or 5, living in Manhattan in New York City. Because I lived in America at such an early age, even if just for 1 year, I actually have this ability to just flawlessly and seamlessly slip into this New York American accent. See, this is just my normal speaking voice because I'm from the southeast of England, and you know, if I just think about what an American accent sounds like, I could just slip into it like this and it's really easy for me. I bet you're really freaked the fuck out now, aren't you? I don't know, I can just slip into it and it just seems really easy and natural for me to speak like this, just as much as it is in my English accent. I've actually been to Florida a lot of times, and every time I go into a supermarket, I just find it quite funny to go up to one of the shop assistants and ask for things in this accent, and they just don't really bat much of an eyelid. No one seems to be able to tell the difference either way, so I could just slip straight back out into my own English accent again, so that's that's a special little party trick I have. I've gone right off topic, haven't I? I want to talk to you about the Nordic countries and how I fell in love with the Nordic countries. So, like I said, I didn't know too much about the rest of the world when I was a kid, even though I was relatively well traveled. That was all changed in 2006, actually. Now, you're gonna think this is a bit of a strange way to actually get to know the rest of the world, but bear with me here, because, you know, when I used to think about learning about geography and history and culture and things like that, and I used to think it was all so boring, and it's like, why would you do that? Why would you go to another country and then just spend all your time walking around looking at castles and going into museums and things like that? It's just like, oh, you're supposed to go on holiday to relax and just lay at the beach and just have the sun and just do nothing. And that was changed in 2006. My attitude and my outlook towards the world was changed in 2006. And that was thanks to music, but not just any music. It was music that came from the Eurovision Song Contest. For those of you who don't know what the Eurovision Song Contest is, it is the most watched non-sporting television event in the entire world. One song from every competing country, and they all go to one international stage somewhere in Europe. They're all performed together in one evening, big spectacular show in a f***ing Olympic-sized stadium most of the time. And then after all the songs have been performed, people vote for their winners via telephone voting. So I want to talk about what the 2006 Eurovision Song Contest did for me and why it made me fall in love with the Nordic countries. So, sort of around the mid-2000s, I was at a point in my life where I did actually have an interest in music, but I didn't really know where to look for music that I enjoyed. You know, I was still at a point where I thought the best music, if you like, could only really be heard on mainstream radio, and it's just not really my cup of tea. Nothing wrong with those artists, just not really my cup of tea. You know, I was always a little bit alternative with my music taste, although in the 90s I did enjoy music, like really sort of bubblegum pop music from the likes of steps. A bit of a steps kid. Especially growing up with Sonic the Hedgehog, as I said in my channel trailer, I guess I kind of had this intrinsic link in my taste to Japanese music. Norway sent a song to the 2006 Eurovision Song Contest that quite literally changed my life and changed my outlook on the entire world. So this song was performed by a folk singer in the Norwegian language, beautiful young woman. Her name is Christine Gudbrandsen. I hope I've said that right. Close as I can get from hearing it in Norwegian over and over again. And the song was called Olverdansen, which in English means the dance of the elves, or elves dance, something like that. It kind of came on TV, and I had my mum and my brother sitting in the living room with me while we all watched the show together, and I wasn't a huge Eurovision fan at the time. I was still kind of just like, oh, what's this on the TV? Okay. You know, my mum and my brother were just kind of talking amongst themselves next to me, and I was kind of just like captivated by what I saw on screen. And the choreography was just so graceful, and the camera, the way it was framed, was just so beautiful. They just looked like this row of angels, and it was really, really beautiful. So it was just this chorus that just came out of the song, and it didn't have any lyrics, but it was just so uplifting and angelic and ethereal, and my God, it just captivated me, and I was just looking at it in absolute wonder. Wow, is this what music from Norway is like? Norway, this comes from Norway. What is Norway like? I mean, I'd heard of Norway before. I knew what their flag looked like, but that's about it, really. So just after watching the show that evening, I went on the internet and I just looked for information about Norway, and I tried to find that song, even though I couldn't actually remember the name of it. And just from looking at YouTube and other videos around at the time of Norway, I just found that these stunning pictures and videos of the fjords and the great lakes and all the mountaintops, and how the sky was just so clear and everything just felt so wide open, and all the whitewashed wooden houses just making the neighbourhoods look so quaint. And at the time I was just so bored and dissatisfied with the UK, and I just felt like there was actually nothing more in the world that I could really find. And, you know, finding this song from Norway and just seeing something that was so different to everything that I knew, I just fell head over heels in love with Norway at that time. And that was in 2006. And so the first time I actually went to Norway was for my 19th birthday. I went on a cruise ship, a very big cruise ship belonging to a company called Royal Caribbean. We sailed out of Southampton, which is on the south coast of the UK, and we sailed all the way up to Stavanger in Norway, which is a city right on the southwestern point. And I was so excited that I was sailing up to Norway, because I was so excited to just see all the fjords and see everything that I'd seen on the internet. And I just wanted to walk around and just listen to Christine Gudbrandsen all day, because I bought like two of her albums in that time. And I got up very, very early on the morning of my actual 19th birthday. That's just when we were docking into Stavanger, so I got up really early. I wanted to see the fjords as we were coming in, because I knew that once we were in the city, we would be kind of away from the fjord area. Just as I came out the doors, I was like, I saw houses on the hills and everything. I was just kind of like, oh no, I'm too late. And I was just kind of like, oh wow, because it was still really beautiful. But there weren't any fjords, but it was still so incredibly beautiful. And I just kind of didn't know what to think at the time. I was like a mixture of just taken aback and a bit disappointed and amazed, and just the quality of the sunlight at sunrise was, it was blindingly bright, the sun. I was watching the sunrise coming over the horizon on the lake in the morning, and the lake was just so incredibly still. It actually looked like a mirror. It was so flat, it looked like mercury. It was the first time that I was just so aware in my mind that I was in another country. Because before that, you know, it was kind of like blurring together in my mind. You know, everywhere that we went, whether it was Switzerland or America or Japan or England or France. It was almost like the world was just one giant country, and I still think that's a healthy way to see the world rather than, you know, glamorizing borders and things like that. And so I walked around exploring and just looking in all the shops, and I just felt so instantly and incredibly at peace and at home there. Oh, I love Norway so much. And it was all started, believe it or not, by a Norwegian entry into the Eurovision Song Contest, a simple performance of a folk song on a stage in Athens on international TV. It changed my life and it made me fall in love with foreign cultures as a whole, but particularly Scandinavia and Norway and the Nordic countries. So stay tuned, because I'm going to be uploading my videos from my trip to Norway in 2011 in full. There's two of them, and they are coming to this channel very soon. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comment section below. I will do my best to get back to you. You're welcome to tweet me as well. I'm at @Rio_Ben. That's @Rio_Ben. There's lots more content coming soon. And there's going to be videos about Japan. I'm going to talk about some music, and I might introduce you to some of my creative projects that I've been working on as part of my work with Blacklight Studios as well. Get in touch, comment, tweet me, share this video around with your friends, and if you enjoyed it, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. So, for now, ciao.